I wasn't hungry when we came in, but now watching this cook for the last 40 minutes, I can't wait to get to the table and eat this. So we've arrived in Mangalore and we are at our first food destination. We are here for lunch at Shetty Lunch Home. How much tea should I put?
That's fine. On the chicken? Yes. Lovely.
Now Shetty Lunch Home has a bit of an interesting story. So the original Shetty Lunch Home was set up in Kundapur in 1957. That is over 60 years ago. So whether it was a chicken ghee roast or the chicken Kundapur or the KANE MASALA fry, these dishes were all invented at Shetty Lunch Home. And we were lucky enough to get access to the kitchen to watch Uma Shetty, the fourth generation of the family that owns Shetty Lunch Home, to take us through the making of some of these amazing dishes. Watch this video till the very end to know what makes his preparations at Shetty Lunch Home truly special. Now Shetty Lunch Home Mangalore is run by the fourth generation of the family that began Shetty Lunch Home Kundapur. So we are here not only to taste but also find out what it is about these dishes or what it is about the way they prepare these dishes that makes them so special. So we are here with Uma and Harish Shetty, who represent the fourth generation of Shetty Lunch Home family. Your recipes have been handed down through generations.
Yeah, from the generations. All right. So my granny started off ghee roast. It's her own recipe. She was a good cook there. So
okay.
She was experimenting and she discovered this. So basically then they used to do it with nati kori.
Okay.
But then because of the cooking time and process, they preferred it with the boiler chicken
Chicken. Okay. We're not only going to taste the chicken ghee roast and the KANE MASALA fry, but Uma has been kind enough to also show us how she prepares the chicken ghee roast and the KANE and what makes it so special.
Bad ghee red chili.
Okay.
It's not the Kashmiri, it's a bad ghee.
It's a bad ghee chili.
Actually, compared to your Kashmiri chili and all, it's less spicy. Then you have the kaju, the poppy seeds, cumin seeds, pepper, dhania, and ginger. So this is soaked in water. So it becomes soft.
Soft. Okay.
Because we need to make a paste out of it.
And this is the
ready masala.
This is the secret sauce.
Yeah.
Right? So your grandmother taught that to her children.
Yes.
And your parents have taught that to you.
Yes. This is the brass tawa.
This is a brass tawa.
Yeah.
Okay.
We prefer cooking it in this.
Because it holds the heat?
Yeah, it holds the heat.
So how much ghee goes into a kilo of chicken?
Around 200 grams.
200 grams, so that's a lot of ghee that's going into it.
So the thing basically, because ghee is expensive, people use dalda and then on top they just put ghee.
But this is pure ghee, 100%.
Ghee is pure ghee.
So this is the masala that has gone into the ghee now. Just the aromas of it are so inviting. I almost want to, you know, I can't wait to get to the chicken ghee roast. Just the aromas are just beautiful. I love the color. You can see that the masala is now getting into the ghee and it's kind of all coming together as one. So you roast the masala for roughly about an hour, is it? How long does it?
Around half an hour.
Half an hour.
Mm-hmm.
the chicken and the masala is now coming nicely together.
So actually the chicken and the masala has to combine, you have to keep putting ghee.
Ah, okay.
So, and it should be cooked.
So you put some more ghee now?
Yes.
Do you want me to put some ghee?
Yes.
How much ghee should I put?
Yeah.
This
That's
is enough
fine,
on
yeah.
the chicken?
Yes.
Lovely. Uma has been cooking this chicken ghee roast for the last 30 minutes now. It's, you know, it's a delicious dish to eat, but there's a lot of work that goes into this. Even before this, the making of the masala, and of course once you put it on the stove on the fire, it's about a 1 hour process. We're only 30 minutes into it, and Uma has been relentlessly stirring it to make sure that the chicken doesn't stick to the pan. And we still have another 30 minutes to go. So she wants the chicken, which is now looking nice, bright, red and orange, to turn deeper in color to a dark reddish brownish. And there's more ghee going into this. The chicken ghee roast, so has to have a lot of ghee in it.
I mean, we can have it with anything.
With anything, right? With neer dosa.
With neer dosa, with bread, with chapati.
Yes.
With roti. A little extra masala and you can have it with anything.
You can just have the masala, right?
Yes. At the last, to give a final touch, we just put a little dhania powder.
Oh, okay. So that gives it aroma.
Gives aroma.
I can smell the coriander powder now. I can smell the dhania with the ghee and the chicken. It's just smelling heavenly.
Colors.
Yes. So the colors have become now darker. You can. It's almost like a reddish brown.
Yes.
It's like the color of rust almost now. Beautiful. Oma has been kind enough to give me a piece of the chicken ghee roast right off the stove, and I can't wait to taste it. First the masala. No, you can taste the chili. You can't really taste much of the spice. You can just taste it as one masala whole. What I like is that the spices are all smoothened by the ghee. They're all very mellow, they're all very smooth. So it's not a dish that really hits you with a lot of chili heat, but it's a very beautifully balanced dish. It's hot. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Super hot here and super humid, and I'm drenched just watching Uma Shetty prepare this beautiful dish, the chicken ghee roast. And while I'm enjoying this dish, Uma is putting together the ingredients for another iconic dish from Shetty Lunch Home, which is a Kane Masala fry.
Popular as the ladyfish may be in this part of the country today, legend has it that this preparation was first served in Shetty Lunch Home, Kundapur.
So we're now going to make the
Kane masala fry.
Kane masala fry. And I see that you have this lovely plump kane or the ladyfish. It comes from a certain area, or where does the ladyfish come from?
We basically get it from Kundapur, Sastan.
From Kundapur, Sastan.
You do get it in Mangalore also now.
Okay.
I prefer river fish.
Okay.
There is sea ladyfish also, but we go for only the river one.
Alright.
Basically, this is again the bad ghee chili. What is again soaked in water.
Okay.
To do the paste. And these are the ingredients, what we put and grind.
Alright.
We use the pepper.
You have pepper.
We have the cumin seed.
Cumin seed.
Ginger.
Ginger.
Garlic. tamarind and turmeric.
And turmeric. Alright.
So now what we do is we cut the fish and we put it in this lime water so that the salt and...
So it marinates for...
Yeah, it marinates for some time.
How long do you marinate the fish?
5-10 minutes.
5-10 minutes, yes. Okay.
So we marinate it, then we marinate little bit in the masala. So right. I have already marinated.
And so we have some fish that's already marinated.
Yes, I have skinned it out.
You have skinned the fish,
yeah.
Okay. So skinned is that what you normally do?
For some customers.
For some customers.
Who are our old customers, they want it skinned out.
Because they want it skinned?
Yes.
But isn't the flavor there in the skin?
It's more oily.
It's more oily,
yes.
Okay. So if you want a diet version of the...
Yeah. So people have it with skin here, yeah? We give it with skin.
Okay.
But our old customers, where my grandmother used to skin it out and give, that's why few of our customers ask it that way, skinned out.
Skinned out, okay, fine. So now we are going to cook the KANE masala fry.
For fish fry, we use coconut oil.
Fish fry, only coconut oil. So the fish has gone into the tawa. So there's a lot of masala that goes into this. How much masala
do you... It should get cooked and dried in the masala.
In the masala, otherwise it will become dry.
Yes, usually here everybody uses the powder masala.
Okay.
We don't use it, we grind, we make our own masala.
So despite the fact that this is an iron, I think just the way it's been seasoned, the oil and the masala,
yes,
the fish is not stuck even the slightest bit to the bottom. And all the masala is going back into the fish. All the masala, so all the richness, all the goodness of that masala is going into that beautiful KANE or the lady fish.
This is that lime and salt.
The seasoning.
Yeah, the lime and salt water.
The lime and salt water, okay. Can I taste a bit of the masala with your permission?
Yes, yes.
Just want to...
It has to still get cooked.
So this masala is not cooked yet, but I can't wait to taste it.
You can get the raw flavor of the chili.
So I can definitely smell the coconut oil.
Yes.
And I think I can get the tart flavor of the tamarind.
Yes.
So the chili and the tamarind is kind of balancing each other very well. And I think the seasoning that you add, which is the lime and all of that, I think comes together.
Having absorbed all the masalas, the KANE fish fry was now ready. And I couldn't wait to dig into this fleshy, flavorful fish fry.
Hot, it's hot. Mm. You taste the fish and you also taste the masala. The masala, despite having all those ingredients, despite having the chili, despite the tamarind and the lime, I think only works to coat the fish. But I can still taste the flavor of the fish. You know, the KANE is a very delicate fish actually. It's not a fish which is very oily, it's not a fish which is very strong in flavor. And while the masala was being cooked, I was wondering whether the KANE, the flavor of the fish will actually get overpowered by the masala. But I'm tasting it, I can taste the masala and I can also taste the fish. And I think they have come together beautifully well. Delicious.
In the next episode, I enjoy a big delicious lunch at Shetty Lunch Home, Mangalore. In addition to tasting the mouth-watering chicken ghee roast and KANE masala fry that we cooked up, I also savored an enormous seafood thali with shrimp, prawns, shellfish and more fish. Click on the video link to catch all of this action.